Good evening, all. I'm Aditi Lamba with the Tuesday night edition of South Asian News, Vision of Asia. We are coming to you from our studio in New Jersey. Welcome to the show. Let's begin the episode taking a look at the coronavirus pandemic and its impact. The world has surpassed 244 million cases of COVID-19 with nearly 5 million deaths. Here in the United States, we are at 45 million cases of COVID-19 and 738,000 deaths. Today, an expert panel voted on whether to recommend a pediatric dose of Pfizer and BioNTech's coronavirus vaccine for children ages 5 to 11. Pfizer has said that its vaccine has shown 90.7% efficacy against the coronavirus in trials of this age group. This comes as cases in unvaccinated kids have risen due to the Delta variant and also due to being back in school. Hence, vaccinating this group will make a huge change in the safety and security of our younger children. Once the FDA authorizes the vaccine for this group, an advisory panel to the US CDC will then make a recommendation on the administration of the vaccine. CDC Director Dr. Walensky will make the final call. Meanwhile, here in New Jersey, a nor'easter slammed into the East Coast and has spurred flash flooding and water rescues. Flash flood watches are in effect from southern New Jersey to northern Massachusetts. If you are here in New Jersey, we hope that you and your family are staying safe inside. With that, let's now take a look at the headlines coming in, covering much on culture and more. Here are the headlines. Asia's BC presents Vibha Select Chef 2021, featuring Michelin star chef Vikas Khanna, New York City. Indian American Forum hosts virtual discussion, Tarlok Malik's To India With Love short film. 16th Annual Navratri and Diwali Celebrations 2021 by Anand Mitra Mandal and Royal Albert's Palace, New Jersey. It's time for a short break on Vision of Asia, South Asian News segment. We'll be right back. And welcome back. I'm Aditi Lamba and this is Vision of Asia, Tuesday night episode of South Asian News. In New York, the Indian American Forum functions as a non-profit organization of Asian Indians in America. The forum takes pride in promoting the cultural, secular heritage and values of India and understanding with people of other cultural backgrounds. The forum hosts numerous events throughout the year with motivated and dedicated volunteers to promote the Indian American community and its contributions. Recently, the Indian American Forum hosted an online discussion on Emmy-nominated Tarlok Malik's short film titled To New India With Love. The short film has been presented by none other than our chairman, Padmashri Dr. Sudeep Parikh and Parikh Worldwide Media, and is a social impact production aimed at creating greater awareness about the role of NRIs in mentoring the Indian youth. The film tells the story of Vijay, a young Indian college student aspiring to leave for America, and his encounter with an NRI professor, Khanna, played by Tarlok Malik. Here are some highlights from the virtual discussion on To New India With Love.
this film has a great message, very relevant message, very contemporary message, and we all should propagate this message, what film is trying to say, that this is a new India, and new India has a great potential. And before migrating from India to here, the young generation should think twice, because there is now a lot of opportunities unlike what we had 50 years ago. That's what my brief comment.
Thank you, Dr. Sudhir Parikh. Thank you so much. And I would now get back to Mr. Tirlok Malik, the maker of the film. In fact, I should have brought him in earlier, but I thought we should have you first make a comment, being the presenter of the movie today. And I would request you, Mr. Malik, so much is known about you, and you have been into this business of filmmaking for a very long time now, and the community knows you so well, not only Indian American community, but there you are known in the mainstream also, having been nominated to Emmy for Emmy Award also, which is a very prestigious award, as great as the Sybil Award that we are all looking for, a Padma Shri or a Padma Bhushan or Ellis Island Award. So congratulations on the nomination. Of course, we will be waiting for you to get the award. Now, my question to you, and that will be followed by a question from Rene also. What prompted you to make this film?
Well, first of all, I want to thank Dr. Sudhir Parikhji for presenting this film and really going all out promoting the film all over the world. Thank you, Dr. Parikh, sir. And I also have my screenwriter, Murtaza Ali Khan, here, who's a very well-known film critic and art critic, done so many hundreds of interviews with all the big stars. Thank you. As a filmmaker, we always sell dreams. It was a dream I wanted to sell, that wherever you are, find an opportunity. Yes, New India is there, but what if you cannot leave India? You cannot come here. Find a way what you can do. And it's a wishful thinking, wishful hope. Even I named the character Vijay, just like Amitabh Bachchan ji in all his films, hoping, just like Vijay in the movie found Professor Khanna as a mentor. A lot of the youth people will find guidance. And yes, India is changing, as Dr. Parikh said. But the idea I feel is Indian youth needs guidance. And India is not without its challenges. India can be made great by Indians living there. So I just wanted to kind of make a very motivational, inspirational film. Thank you, sir.
This month, Indian festival season has begun with Navratri. The 9-day very popular festival usually falls in the months of September and October annually. Navratri is then followed by Dussehra, which is then followed by Indian Festival of Lights Diwali. The main theme of most of these festivals this season is to celebrate the victory of good over evil, light over darkness, right over wrong. Not only do these festivals bring community together, they provide an occasion to celebrate Indian culture and heritage and its long-lasting traditions. The festivals are also a moment to look within oneself and evaluate if you are doing good to yourself and the society, as being a good humanitarian human is the foundation of Indian values and morals. Many celebrations have been visible across the country on the festival season, and recently, the Anand Mitra Mandal, along with Albert Jasani of the Royal Abbot's Palace in New Jersey, hosted 16th annual Navratri and Diwali celebrations, an evening of Indian music, Garba, and food. Here are some highlights.
On behalf of the Brooklyn Borough President Eric L. Adam, I would like to present this Brooklyn Borough President honor. During the COVID-19, Dipti Benjani has worked so hard for the community. So on behalf of the Brooklyn Borough President, I would like to present this citation to Dipti Jani. Congratulations, Dipti ji.
Oh, Dipti Jani, Dilip Bhai Chauhan, tatha Eric no khub khub abhar mano chu. Just, you know, Dipti Jani, thank you.
today we are very proud of Diti Benjani because she is the woman who worked so hard for COVID-19 and she got an honor today at the Navratri Garba and his honor is given by Dilip Bhai Chauhan and team. So I am really great that Diti Ben, congratulations for your all achievement, for your all help, for your all community services. Thank you very much.
Every year Albert and Sobna Ben doing the best Garba in Edison. And we always support him. This is a family garba. This is the best one. Thank you.
Dipti Ben is doing the good job for the community. She deserves the proclamation from the mayor. Her husband, you know, Surajani was a good friend of mine. He did a lot of community work until he died. Happy Diwali and Navratri and Happy New Year. From Royal Albert Palace.
चर चौके मोरीमा दीवड़ो प्रगटाव्यो गब्बर गोखे मोरीमा। आणंद मित्र मंडल तरफ थी आजे मने गरबा गावानो मौको मळ्यो छे अहींया आल्बर्ट पैलेस में। आई एम थैंकफुल टू द आणंद मित्र मंडल कमिटी आल्बर्ट भाई। आठमू नोरतु चाली रहेलू छे अने एटला सरस मजाना गरबा अहींया लोको गाई रहेला छे। माय को सिंगर मीता बेन, राजू भाई पटेल, मयंक भाई पटेल एंड ऑफ कोर्स केसी पटेल, एवरीवन आर हियर एंड एन्जॉइंग द गरबा। थैंक यू आईटीवी फॉर कवरेज। थैंक यू सो मच। हैप्पी नवरात्रि। जय माता दी। रॉक। थैंक यू।
इट्स नाउ टाइम फॉर अदर शॉर्ट ब्रेक ऑन विजन ऑफ एशिया, वॉइस ऑफ द कम्युनिटी। डोंट गो एनीवेयर, वी विल बी राइट बैक। एंड वेलकम बैक। आई एम नितिन लामा एंड दिस इज विजन ऑफ एशिया साउथ एशियन न्यूज़ सेगमेंट। Over the last 27 years, Vibha Nonprofit has been able to identify, fund, and scale up several solutions that have created a large-scale social impact benefiting millions of children of India. Dedicated to educating, empowering, and enabling the most underserved children, Vibha is run by sheer volunteer efforts through fundraisers, monitoring project investments, running awareness camps, forging corporate partnerships, and also mentoring social entrepreneurs. Recently, Vibha brought together a very unique event featuring none other than Michelin star chef Vikas Khanna. Called HSBC Presents Vibha Select Chef 2021, the event was a cooking competition between Indian Americans passionate for cooking on a concept very similar to Chef Khanna's very popular MasterChef TV show. We have tonight highlights from Vibha Select Chef 2021 featuring Michelin star chef Vikas Khanna along with members of Vibha and HSBC. Here is the story.
Hello everyone, I'm Aditi Lama and you're watching ITV Gold. Today I am here with cameraman Manish and we are in New York City for Vibha Select Chef 2021. This is an amazing show which features none other than Michelin star Vikas Khanna here at his premises where he'll be choosing a winner out of three contestants. All of this is happening to encourage the word of Vibha, an amazing nonprofit that educates, enables, and empowers the most underserved children of India. So stay tuned with us here on ITV Go, where we bring you all the happenings of Select Chef 2021. I'm Vidhi Lamba.
Clear? You ready to go? 1, 2, 3, start!
Started.
and we are here at Vibha Select Chef, and I'm joined by none other than Michelin star chef Vikas Khanna. Thank you so much for your time on ITV Gold. You know, I have to ask you, just starting this was a big project that you took up, and to, you know, make something similar to MasterChef and bring it here to New York City and feature Indian Americans. How did you come up with this entire thought?
I've been working with Vibha for some time, and I'm very proud of what they do. So when we were discussing something that, you know, let's do something of a celebration of what benchmarks they have achieved as a foundation. So we couldn't think of anything better than cooking. And we came up with the idea, and Kayul came up with the idea, let's do Select Chef 2021. We invite people from all over America, and we select the recipes and bring them here, give them a challenge like MasterChef, and do something amazing.
You know, I have to ask you, we are talking about Vibha, and Vibha does so much work for the, you know, underserved communities of India and other communities around the world as well. How important do you think it is for us right now to support a cause like Vibha? And, you know, what motivates you to keep on connecting with them?
I think more so than ever before, we need to be more involved, because after the pandemic, the whole economy of the world has been shattered. There's been a huge unbalanced parts of the world right now. When we're looking at the places which are only supported by different foundations and contributions of people. And I think plugging it into good foundations which are working back home in India for us. And that's the first thing I said here, you know, for me, Vibha is like, of course, I live with the pain and guilt like every NRI who's left their parents back home to age and to make a better life for ourselves in a different direction. I think Vibha reduces that pain for me, because I know that I'm reaching out not just to my parents or cities, I'm reaching out to many more people around me.
Millions of children are being helped by Vibha. You know, I have to ask you now, let's talk a little bit more about you and what's going on. You have a book that has come out, your 37th book. So let's talk a little bit about it. How excited are you? And, you know, what was that journey, you know, to have this book released this year?
So I didn't work last year because I was doing Feed India. So I have a huge workload which has to be released in forms of movies, books, restaurants, everything. But this book is very important because it's about holistic cooking. And I think sometimes, especially now, we all need healing in some ways. And looking outward is not the question right now. Looking inward and towards the wisdom of ancestors, I think that's more important to me. And that's what this book has done. It's called Back to Our Roots. It's 100 recipes which are totally vegetarian, done very much on the similar principles of Ayurveda, but also in a very modern way, where people at home have stuff in the pantry and they can cook these dishes.
We have all seen a lot since last year.
Yes.
There was a huge impact on India. We cannot forget the impact on education. So what is happening on Vibha's end right now to educate all these children that they've been serving so far? And how did you have to change your programs, you know, adjusting to the pandemic?
Yeah. So, you know, in Vibha, we serve the underprivileged children.
Yeah.
So, as you know, schools were closed. So rural India was much more affected than anywhere else.
Right.
COVID situation was even worse there.
Yeah.
So all people cared about was to survive, you know.
Mm.
And we realized that, you know, we should get into a disaster recovery mode. Again, we collaborated with Vikas. We raised about $2.6 million.
Yeah.
We had a hospital built in, a makeshift hospital built in Bangalore,
yeah,
with Texas Instruments. And besides that, the need of the hour was oxygen concentrators.
Mm.
So we were able to get oxygen concentrators to about 25 states in India, 1,100 concentrators. We went as high as Jammu and Kashmir.
Yeah.
And I cannot tell you how much effort it was to make sure that they reach the right places,
yeah,
because everything was shut down.
Exactly.
The other most important thing that happened at that time was food. You know, people didn't have food. So, you know, we collaborated with our partners and made sure that not just the children that we serve, but even their surrounding communities, their families, they all got food because they needed to survive at that point. So we did that. And then above all, we got into a little bit digital mode. You know, adversity brings the best out of you. And, you know, in Vibha, it's a volunteer-driven organization. We are all technocrats. Yeah. So we all understood what technology can do.
Yeah.
So we started giving out smartphones to kids.
Oh, wow.
The interesting part is, believe it or not, most of the states have their syllabus online. And, you know, you can get YouTube videos and all that. It's just like somebody has to put things together. And our teachers, our field staff, and everybody who works for Vibha, they were so good that we were able to send out a lot of these digital devices. And that brought us into a new era where now we feel so strongly that digital can change even going ahead.
Joining us from HSBC is Jaspreet. HSBC is the sponsor for Vibha Selection of 2021 today. Thank you so much for giving us your time on ITV Gold. Just have one question for you. HSBC has been working for years and years to serve all the communities around them, including the South Asian American community. I'd like for you to tell our viewers, what is HSBC doing on a local level, and how can they find some resources and help from HSBC?
Sure. So, hi, thank you, everybody. My role at HSBC, I lead the NRI desk in the US. And what we do for the community is, you know, we help people connect back home. Most of these people, you know, they have families back where they live. HSBC being one of the leading international banks, I think that's the goal, that how we connect people back to their homeland, you know, help with them with their financial needs. And I think, this year, we wanted to do something different. So we thought of Vikas and Vibha together. We've done something with Vibha in the past few months. And I thought that this was a great opportunity for us to, you know, celebrate the spirit of Diwali. And I resonate a lot with Vibha as an organization because, you know, coming back from India, I think I've gone through what Vibha helps doing children. So, you know, that's something resonates with me. So I think this is great, and just wanted to wish everybody, you know, a very, very happy Diwali.
With this, we wrap up our show for the night. Please send us your suggestions and get your voices and organizations on our show. Email us on events@itvgold.com or follow us on our Facebook handle @itvgold. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel for many popular shows. Thank you for joining us tonight from Edison, New Jersey. This is Vision of Asia, and I am Niti Lamba. Take care and be well.